Good afternoon, Los Angeles. I'm Robert W. Morgan. John Stewart has been with me since his show began nearly 5 weeks ago. And now because of a lot of personal and professional commitments, he has to leave. This is his last show. And also because, as he says, he has to get back to his people, a lot of which, as you can see, are with us today. When I first heard John's music, I really dug it right away, man. The songs that he writes and the way he sings them. But during the last 5 weeks, I've gotten to know the man, and that's what really turns me on. In this lifetime, there are very few people you can call friend, but John is a friend of mine. And if I'm not a better person because of knowing John Stewart, then I'm in pretty bad shape to start out with. Pick and sing, Joaquin.
Had I been born in New York City, New York City girl at me, looking in the concrete, not the sunlight, living in that New York raining snow. Oh, there's a California bloodlines in my heart, there's a California woman in my song. Yeah, there's California bloodlines in my heart, and just to think I might have never known you if I had lived my life in Tennessee. But I really could have never let that happen, 'cause you in California are in me. Oh, there's California bloodlines in my heart, there's a California woman in my soul. Bloodlines in my heart, with a California heartbeat in my soul. Yeah, there's California bloodlines in my heart, and a California woman in my soul. Yeah, there's California bloodlines in my heart, and a California heartbeat in my soul.
Hold the applause down.
Thanks, Coyote. Your new guitar. This one sounds terrible.
I know. I made it myself. It's an old Heath kit.
I know you all saw Easy Rider.
Peter Fonda on a sickle, riding with the wind. Well, this is a story that was about a guy who had a 32 Plymouth that he could barely get out of the garage. And he was known as the Oklahoma Tripper. Chris Darrell starts it off.
Good friend by the name of Rosalie. got my two-time total car. Got my good out of star. I got a heart full of woman and a belly full of Tennessee.
Well, Joaquin, I know you must do what you must do, man, but I want to say I hate to see you go, that's all.
Well, Coyote, I want you to know that in a way I hate to go, but I've got to go out there. Back to the land, Coyote, this Hollywood phoniness, you know. Stinking concrete city. I autograph Sam Riddle, bugs me every day, the phone calls, you understand? I can't take it. I got to get back to where I really belong.
Joaquin, honey, your limousine is here.
Last Saturday night at the concert at UCLA, before you came out, there was a chick there that was dressed pretty groovy and sang pretty wild, Linda Ronstadt. And there was a guy in her band by the name of Chris Darrow.
That's right.
Yeah, tell me about him.
Chris Darrow is an old friend from Pomona who is about to be in my band, whether he likes it or not. Mr. Alligator Man, Chris Darrow.
Thank you, man.
Coast called Bolinas, and it's a beautiful little town, and it's our most favorite in the whole world, but soon it will be gone, but this song won't. Time in Bolinas is so very small, the clock on the courthouse ain't working at all, and the mayor of Bolinas is digging for clams. But folks in Bolinas, they don't give a damn.
Two little figures far down the road, chasing the train as far as they go. But the train disappears in its own westward dot,
And the two little figures now stand on the spot where all that mighty iron had rolled. And the track now is cold. When the world was spinning a song and it whistled the wind, carry it on. When the world was spinning a song and it whistled the wind, carry it on. Time in Bolinas is so very small, the clock on the courthouse ain't working at all, and the mayor of Bolinas is digging for clams, but folks in Bolinas, they don't give a damn.
I know there's a wild, far-out chance that if I really worked at it and really got to you, I could maybe talk you into staying, but I know that wouldn't be right for you, so I don't think I'll try even.
Coyote, if it was you, I'd stay, but it's more than that. It's the land, and it's being the real me. I can't let these agents and managers and accountants and car hops tell me what to do. I've got to let be natural. I've got to let Mother Nature decide who I'm to be.
Joaquin, honey, the hairstylist just called, and he had to cancel your appointment because the manicurist is out sick.
John and I have a friend who's a very good photographer. In fact, he's taken a lot of pictures for the album covers of the big artists Crosby, Stills, and Nash, and the
my
Turtles.
Favorite. This is my favorite album cover of all.
What, the Turtles?
The Turtles, yeah.
I've often thought this would make a great Valentine.
Send it.
And Arlo Guthrie and John Stewart and Richard Pryor, a lot of people.
We
Richard
also,
Harris.
Took the great portraits in the Life Woodstock special article.
This
probably
man,
the top rock photographer, there is such a thing in the country.
Yeah. This man has also taken pictures of Joaquin and myself, and they have turned out to be probably the worst pictures.
Worst since the booth broke down at Lincoln Park.
I could not have looked that bad. Ever in my life.
I don't go out of the room for 2 days after I see the proof sheets.
No, I never, and I every time I say I'm never going to speak to him again, but I always end up doing it.
Someday we'll take his picture.
His name is Henry Diltz, and John Stewart has written him a song, and Henry Diltz is going to pick and sing that song right now. We got some great shots of him. Ladies and gentlemen, this song is called Wheaties in the Afternoon.
That misfit, ne'er-do-well, good-for-nothing night person me. That's the way I'm looked upon by the vast majority. But I just make music and I sing the midnight tune. And then I sleep away the mornings and have Wheaties in the afternoon. No bus stop, time clock, small talking mornings for me. It's that good time, red wine, sublime midnight till three. But I just make music and I sing the midnight tune. Then I sleep away the mornings and have Wheaties in the afternoon. It's that pre-dawn, half gone, sing all the songs once again. Mingle and tingle and single and out some old friend. But I just make music and I sing. Wheaties in the afternoon.
Henry Diltzen, Wheaties in the Afternoon. Come on in, Henry.
Bully job.
Hi, Joaquin.
Now, those pictures will be available right after the show. And they'll come in very handy as passport photos if you want to get into Warsaw on the QT. Henry shoots a lot of things, and all kidding aside, with the exception of John and myself, you do very good work.
Oh, thank you.
Henry's favorite thing to shoot photographically in the world is...
Nudes. Nudes galore.
Fire hydrants, right, Henry?
Yeah, that's right.
I don't really
think
that, in spite of what a lot of people say, I don't really think that's a hang-up. I think now's the time. We already saw them in Tiger Beat. Why don't you show them on this
okay.
first time? Henry Diltz and his fire hydrants.
Well, starting off right here, we have... that's a New York fire hydrant right there with a green puddle next to it. I don't know what the puddle is, but there it was.
It's like a green puddle to me.
Yeah. And next we have this. This is, Madison, Wisconsin, I think, with the Lovin' Spoonful. It was on tour with them.
Real good and likeness.
The thing about these hydrants is that every city or every town, in fact, every county, has a different color and different shaped fire hydrant, you know.
So. Where is your favorite fire hydrant?
there we have.
What's that? Looks like the head of a lady, Henry.
Yeah. Well,
there we go.
Yeah.
That's the next one.
Yeah.
Explain.
This is Zalianovsky lighting a hydrant on fire in Kansas City, Missouri.
Wait a minute. Back up a little bit, Henry. I thought you said it was Zali lighting a fire hydrant on fire.
Yeah, I did, John.
No, he didn't say it.
He's lighting a fire hydrant.
He's putting us on, John. You know
with
how
his
is.
New Playboy lighter, I believe it was.
Well, you know why Zali left the country.
Do you believe in reincarnation, Henry? No, tell me
well,
the
there's
truth.
There's the lady.
Yeah, I do. Huh?
Were you ever a dog?
No, I don't think so. this is it's in Santa Monica right here. This is, I believe it's Hart Street. Some artists put that. L.A. has mostly yellow fire hydrants.
Why is that, do you think, basically? Does that tell us something about it?
I don't know. It's not very imaginative. I mean, you know, all of them are yellow, just about. This is, John, this is on tour with you, I think. This is in Boston.
Oh, yeah, I recognize that.
Yeah, that's
in Boston, right outside
He does it every day for the last 5 weeks.
I was behind the
sign outside the
trying
trailer
to
park.
Get rid of a bad hickey.
This is in L.A., again, yellow fire hydrant. Sort of an action shot there with a
looks a lot like Moriarty.
He was out of time. That was, it was the acting fire hydrant.
This is Sunset Strip here when they had the old remember that old sign there with the revolving girl?
Oh, right, from the Myra Breckenridge girl.
Got a lot of hang-ups, Henry. I take back what I said before. There is a fire hydrant.
Like Henry.
Oh. This is on Melrose in La Cienega, this particular one, outside a poodle grooming place there.
By the way, I might add, this particular fire hydrant is especially beautiful this time of year.
You might add, yes.
Is that it?
That's it.
Let's have a round of applause for Henry Diltz. Real
good, Henry.
And his fire hydrants.
Far
is it your dream, like maybe to capture on the 35mm film every fire hydrant in America?
I would like to, yeah. I'd like to get a Ford grant. Travel around the country.
You were going to put him on? Are you kidding? Well, listen, man, I really hope for your sake and for John's sake and for some weird reason mine that Wheaties in the Afternoon is a big smash record.
Well, thanks a lot, Bob. Thank you
for bringing your fire hydrants down.
Well, thank you.
And thank you for picking and singing. Now for a great finale on John Stewart's last day on the Robert W. Morgan Show, we thought we'd have one great, huge sing-along. Go, man, and get set up with your people. And a song that John wrote about a little town. He wrote at a little town, about a little town, and about the wind that blows there up in Northern California. Joaquin and his people.
What Robert says is true. The town is called Marshall, California. And I swear to you, as I stand here on this day, someday, not too far off, Joaquin and Coyote shall ride again. Sunday song. The day is long. She wore the yellow dress just to keep me happy till the day was done. Out on Highway 1, dancing off the bottles was the Sunday sun. I'm singing, singing,
singing,
singing,
singing
a song. Won't you sing along? Sing along at home, too.
La 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 la
Well, Joaquin, I guess this is it, man.
Cody. That's not it. I
can't do it either.
There comes a time when a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. Sure, I'm gonna miss a lot of you folks in L.A. who sent in those nice card and letter. But someday, when you least expect it, and the wind is off the hills and Santana's blowing off Topanga Canyon, you'll turn. There on the hill, you'll find Joaquin. But right now, I gotta go because, well, Glenn Campbell says I have to have his car washed by Sunday.
John, before you leave, there's something I want you to have.
What's that, Kyle?
Something that's very much a part of me, and that I want to give it to you to always remember me by, okay?
Oh, gee,
it's my very favorite horseshoe.
Gee, it still has a horse on it.
That came from my Volkswagen bus, and I want you to have it. Thank you, man. Thank you, Joaquin. Thank you, Joaquin's people. And thank you, Los Angeles.
La, la.